Saturday night, 48 Hours investigates a murder mystery just outside Washington, D.C. The victim was a friend of this couple. He was found inside their studio apartment after being attacked with a knife. But the couple's story took a bizarre turn when they were in custody. Here's a preview of Richard Schlesinger's report.
We're stacked up kind of like how we are now. One guy.
Officer Dean Skiba was working the night shift near Washington, D.C. when he got the kind of call young cops train for and pray they never get.
How bloody was this apartment that day?
It's like a horror movie. You can see it is up all over the wall, all over the ground.
In October 2013, Mark Waugh, a promising 23-year-old law student, was stabbed to death in the tiny apartment where his friends Rahul Gupta, a grad student, and Gupta's girlfriend, Taylor Gold, a biomedical engineer, lived. They'd started the evening bar hopping, but ended it handcuffed and in police custody.
Taylor? Here, can you hop up for a minute? And your first name, R?
R-A-H-U-L.
They were brought in drunk and bloody. Detective Paula Hamill thought it would be an open and shut case because Gupta told Officer Skiba that he did it and why.
I caught my buddy and my girl cheating. I killed my buddy.
But Hamill quickly realized she was in for a long day.
All I remember is Rahul telling me to call 911.
How did he end up bloody?
Good question.
As Gupta sobered up, he changed his story. Now he insisted he had no idea how Mark Waugh was stabbed.
I know that I didn't do anything to cause Mark to start bleeding. I know that for a fact. I did not attack Mark.
Okay.
Put that on the record.
Did you get the sense that he was inserting the denials into the conversation?
Yeah, like conveniently, like whenever he could.
Hamill was sure one of them did it. And strangely, though Taylor Gold insisted she didn't remember, she couldn't say for sure it wasn't her.
Did you kill Mark?
I don't think so. Why would I?
I remember what happened. I told you everything I did remember.
Did you believe her?
I didn't believe her then, and I still don't believe her now. And I don't know that we believed either one of them.
After hours of questioning, Detective Hamill brought them together.
I did not stab him.
I don't think I did either.
This conversation could decide who goes home and who goes to prison for murder.
Richard Schlesinger is with us now. Good morning, Richard.
Morning.
We're so used to forensics nowadays. Don't they tell us something in this case?
Well, they do in most cases, but in this case, Taylor Gold and Rahul Gupta lived in that apartment, so it wouldn't be surprising at all to find their DNA, all sorts of forensic evidence all over the place. Right. That was one of the challenges in this case. I will say there was other evidence that helped them reach the conclusion that they did.
And you said they were all friends. I'm thinking friends like that, you don't need enemies. I've never heard anybody say, I don't remember stabbing someone.
Well, you know, funny you should mention that, because I've been doing this for more time than I like to admit, and it was a first for me, too. The interesting thing about this story that caught our attention is the lengthy interrogation and what went on, and it's all on tape, was fascinating.
And they're so young.
And it broke the case.
So young.
Richard, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. You can catch the full report. What happened in apartment 1601 Saturday night at 10, 9 Central. It's part of 48 Hours, a double feature here on CBS.